making there?
Well, we're making the famous Cleveland Heights style hot dog soup. What you do is you chop up one of them, these kind of onions. And then you chop up your hot dogs. Some people like to call them Franks. Some people call them wieners. I call them hot dogs. After you remove the plastic wrapper around the hot dogs, you want to kind of get them on a cutting board like this. See, you kind of use your hand a little bit, and you tap it with the side of the knife like this, kind of like you're spanking it. You're spanking it. And then some people like to cut it like real little. Some people like it real big. I like it just like this. Now watch your hands now. All right. We got everything we need right here. So, the next step is very important. The water. Gotta have just the right amount of tap water. Let's see, that looks about, feels right. Yeah. See that much. Now, you pop your can of beer open like this. See, like that's got that tab right there. I like to be room temperature. This one happens to be cold, but you kind of pour it in like this. That way it kind of mixes with the water. Don't put the whole thing in. Not the whole thing. Okay. Now this is the broth. Okay? We call it the broth in the cooking world. I don't know what you might call it out there. It doesn't really matter how you refer to it. It's a liquid vehicle that carries the rest of the ingredients. Now we're at the point where things start to get busy. Take a cutting board. Well, some people do it different. I do it like this. Some people like to use their hands, but I like to be real sanitary. So I take the knife and I just start to plunk those chopped up hot dogs, some people call them wieners, into your broth. Like that, see? Sometimes they roll up and fall on the floor, that's okay. You just pick them up off the floor, it's okay, it's still good. There. You want to kind of slosh it around a little bit? Slosh. Then, the secret ingredient. This here is your yellow onion. You might recall the early portion of the show, we chopped this up. Now we're going to just take that, dump it in like real fast like that. And that scares the hot dogs. Makes more flavor come out. You mix it with the knife like this. Some people like to use a spoon. I use a knife. There. Now, at this point, we assess, is there enough broth? What do you think out there at home? I think use a little bit more. A little bit more broth. There. A little bit more. Okay. Now it's time, ladies and gentlemen, our TV audience. It depends. Like, you could take the top off like this if you want to, but then it all come running out real fast. It's hard to judge. So what I like to do, people don't know this, but there's actually a plastic tab on here. You pop it back like that, it just kind of squirts out. So here, let's go over that. Tab, squirt, no top, pour. Okay. Now we're going to add the red hot sauce. I like to use Frank's red hot sauce, but you could use other sauce. Now, when you look at a broth like this, you say, that's 8 shakes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You ask me how do I know that? I don't know. It's just a touch thing. You'll get the hang of it. Now, it's ready to simmer. But what you like to do is let it sit before you simmer it. So you do the cold. It's like a brine. You got it? It's like a brine. So we're going to start right now. We're going to wait for it to kind of soak in. Then I'll show you what goes on the stove. Let the hot dog and the onion and the red hot sauce start to kind of get to know each other, is how I like to put it.
How high the heat.
And then my assistant, Warner, he won't let me operate the stove because dangerous things have happened in the past. Let's see. Yeah, that's just about right. That's just how you want it. Now, you can kind of mix it. You don't have to mix it too much. You don't want to bruise anything. There you go. And now that Warner's not looking, we're going to turn the heat up. Which one is it? This one. Whoa. Uh-oh, it's broken. There. A little bit higher heat, I think. Okay, come back in a little while, because we have to bring it to a boil. So I'll see you later. We are in our creation. Oh, yeah. See, that's how it's supposed to look. When all those little chunks of hot dog, some people like to call them wiener, float to the top, then you know it's ready. Except, I forgot, you gotta do the Cool Hand Luke style salt and pepper treatment. Now you get them both in your hand like this. You remember Cool Hand Luke when he spreads the spice for the bloodhounds that are chasing him? Just like that. And you go like that. See? Just like that. Perfect. Then what you do is you put these back down. Pick up your spoon. Mix that in again. Got that. Then I turn off the heat and let it come down to room temperature. We'll see when it's at room temperature. The final stage of the incredible Cleveland Heights style hot dog soup. Now we've let it cool to room temperature. It's ready to serve. Yeah, what you want to do is you want to reach in with the spoon. I usually use a ladle, but they would only give me a spoon. And I take a healthy portion, and I drop it in a bowl. Thusly, I like to say thusly. You know, some people like more of the broth. Some people like more of the hot dogs. I'm kind of in between. There we go. As you can see, everything's congealed nicely. We have a spoon, we have our bowl, and then the final touch, you take the Lay's. You go like this. See that? Got that? You sprinkle that on there, and then